वेलकम बैक टू प्रैक्टिकल सेशंस ऑफ फ्लूइड मैकेनिक्स। दिस पर्टिकुलर सेशन और दिस पर्टिकुलर प्रैक्टिकल सेशन वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस द एक्सपेरिमेंट दैट इज रेनॉल्ड्स एक्सपेरिमेंट और रेनॉल्ड्स अपैरेटस। द कंटेंट ऑफ द एक्सपेरिमेंट्स एज यूजुअल दैट एम एंड ऑब्जेक्टिव्स देन स्पेसिफिकेशन ऑफ द इक्विपमेंट देन रिलेवेंट थ्योरी प्रोसीजर पार्ट एक्चुअल परफॉर्मेंस ऑफ एक्सपेरिमेंट देन ऑब्जर्वेशंस एंड सैंपल कैलकुलेशंस एंड कंक्लूजंस। As far as aim and objectives of this experiment is concerned, in this experiment we are going to visualize the flow based on the observation on based on the characteristic of laminar and turbulent flow using Reynolds apparatus, and at the same time we will validate that flow by calculating the Reynolds number. So determination of Reynolds number and flow visualization of laminar and turbulent flow using Reynolds apparatus, this is the aim of the experiment. As per Reynolds has performed many experiments taking different diameter pipes with water at different temperature, and from these experiments Reynolds concluded that for various parameters on which the regimes of flow depend can be grouped together in a single non-dimensional parameter that is called as a Reynolds number. Basically Reynolds number is the ratio of inertia force and viscous force. So as far as the Reynolds number is concerned, it is inertia force upon viscous force. So inertia force is mass into acceleration. So by rearranging the term, so we get this expression of inertia force. Viscous force is shear stress into area, that is shear area. Again, after rearranging, we get this expression. And by taking ratio, we'll get this expression of Reynolds number, that is VL by nu, where L is the characteristic length. For pipe flow, where the linear dimension is taken as diameter, the characteristic length is the diameter. For flow over a flat surface, this is characteristic length is the length. Characteristic length means the length along which the happening is taking place. So as far as the pipe flow is concerned, the velocity varies along the diameter. That's why D is considered as characteristic length. And the characteristic varies along length in case of external flow. That's why length is considered as a characteristic length for external flow. So this is the expression of Reynolds number. Reynolds number signifies the relative predominance of inertia force to viscous force in the flow regions. So this number is taken as a criteria for dynamic similarity in the flow situations where the viscous forces predominant, for example, that the motion of submarine, low velocity flow around automobiles and aeroplanes, the incompressible flow through pipes and small sizes, flow through low speed turbo machines. So where there is a relative magnitude. So in initial flow, that laminar flow, that viscous force are dominant over the inertia force. That's why Reynolds number is low. While in turbulent flow, the inertia force dominant over the viscous force. That's why Reynolds number is very high. So generally this number is used to recognize the type of flow as well. And the purpose of this experiment is to illustrate the influence of Reynolds number on pipe flows. Here the Reynolds number is very useful dimensionless quantity, that is the ratio of dynamic force to viscous force, that aids to classifying a certain types of flows. So for example, that laminar flow case, the Reynolds number is value is comparatively low, because there the viscous force is dominant because of the viscous nature of the fluid as well as the low velocity of the flow we can consider, or the low that a fluid is passing through a very small cross section. That's why for incompressible flow in a pipe, Reynolds number based on the pipe diameter, it also Reynolds number serves the ratio that is rho Vd by mu. So generally laminar flow is low. So it is found that from the experiment, if the Reynolds number is less than suppose 2100, so or 2000, then the flow remains laminar. If it falls between 2000 to 4000, the flow is unstable, that is in transition zone. And if it exceeds 4000, then the flow becomes turbulent. In that case, large eddies are generated and the complete rapid mixing of fluid particles taking place that we are going to see physically also. So this number is helpful for identification of the type of flow also. And once we identify the type of flow, later on, we can use the suitable expression for analysis. So this experiment will illustrate laminar, transitional, and turbulent flows in the pipe, as well as with the help of Reynolds number, we are going to validate the same as well. So laminar and turbulent flow that already we have studied in second topic, that is laminar flow is one in which the path taken by individual particle do not cross. You can see you cannot visualize the flow because they do not cross their path. Only by disturbing the flow we come to know that flow is taking place and move along, because all the particles are moving along well-defined path. And this type of flow is called as a laminar flow. And generally the oil flow through capillary, flow of blood in veins and groundwater flow, that is a laminar flow. So most of the flow of thick fluid or the low velocity, the laminar flow exists. But turbulent flow, the flow in which there is a rapid movement of the fluid takes place and the fluid particles move in an entirely haphazard or disorderly manner. The high velocity flow, suppose you can compare, this is a turbulent flow, entirely the fluid particles move in an haphazard or disorderly manner. The high velocity flow in conduit of large section, nearly all fluid flow problems encountered in engineering practice have a turbulent character. So these are the two classes of turbulent flow. We are going to visualize this type of, this nature of the flow, that is laminar and turbulent flow, in this particular experiment. Reynolds conducted an experiment for observations and determination of these flow regimes of flow. And by introducing a fine filament of dye into the flow of water through a glass tube at its entrance, he studied the different types of flow. And at low velocity, the dye filament appears as a straight line through the length of the tube and parallel to it, its axis. And according to its behavior, he characterized that as a laminar flow. Then as the velocity is increased, the dye filament becomes wavy throughout the indicating transition flow. On further increasing the velocity, the filament breaks up and diffuses completely in the water in the glass tube, indicating the turbulent flow as well. So this is the basics of the experiment. Now the equipment used here, this is a simple equipment, which mainly consists, the stopwatch is required, measuring flask is required for measuring flow, consequently for calculation of Reynolds number. And this is a Reynolds apparatus, which consists of a water tank having a glass tube, glass tube leading out of it. So this is a water tank having the glass tube. The glass tube has a bell mouth at the entrance and a regulating wall at the outlet. A dye container, that is, this is a dye container with an arrangement for injecting a filament. So here the filament is injected. So obviously the head of this dye is at a higher level than the water level in the tank. And the filament at entrance of the glass. So potassium permanganate that chemical is used to create or to produce this particular dye. It is added in the water. So the characteristic of dye is similar to the characteristic of the water. So that we can, only that purpose of dye is to recognize the flow regimes or recognize the nature of the flow. That is the purpose. So that is injecting here with the help of any injector, and that we can visualize the flow in this glass tube. So here the diameter of the glass tube is 10 mm. We can calculate the cross-sectional area of the glass tube, which is 7.85 into 10 raised to 5. That is by using pi by 4 disco. That is required for calculating the velocity and later on the Reynolds number. Dynamic viscosity, as this is water, the standard water is considered, which dynamic viscosity is 1 into 10 raised to minus 6 meters square per second. this is as per the specifications of the equipment. Now we'll see the actual performance through animation, because most of the trial, it is very difficult to visualize the flow. So because animation, we could able to understand exactly the physics behind it. So this is the animation part. This is a dye tank. And this is the glass tube, you can see. And, this is a water tank. This is a glass tube. This is a water tank, and the ink is injected from this glass tube. Now we can regulate the flow with the help of this regulating valve, and we can collect the water here. So this is the injector through which the dye inject. Obviously, the head of the dye is getter, so the flow is taking place. So this is obviously at high pressure. So you can see at a very low velocity, the thin filament of is appear in the glass tube. So we can recognize that flow is laminar. So that is generally happening at a very low velocity. So you can regulate the flow. And with slight increasing velocity, you can see these waves. So this is a transition flow, or we can see the filament becomes unstable. So this is with further increasing the flow, that film is completely diffused in the entire cross section. And you can visualize the entire glass tube is filled with the color water. And if the further increase, that complete filament disappears as well. So this way we can recognize the flow, and at the same visualization, we can measure the flow, calculate the velocity and calculating the Reynolds number. And then they validate the flow as well at the end of the experiment. So in this particular experiment, we are going to visualize the type of flow in the glass tube. And for a particular flow, if that visualization is laminar, so we measure the flow in the tank, or maybe in the measuring flux, and we calculate the flow rate. Then after calculation of flow rate, we calculate the Reynolds number, calculate the velocity of flow in the pipe. Then we calculate the Reynolds number, that is Vd by nu. So diameter of the pipe known to us, velocity we have measured, kinematic viscosity known to us. And then the calculated Reynolds number, if it is less than 2000, and if the appeared flow or visual flow is laminar, then our observation is verified. So this is a simple experiment. Which is generally used, the main purpose of this experiment is to validate the fundamental things. So why the definitions are introduced, that is laminar, turbulent and transition. So these definitions we can easily validate using our physical observations. So this is the main purpose of this Reynolds experiment. So now this observation table, 7 readings have been taken. So the time required to collect 1000 cc water, that time is measured, that is in this particular experiment, the volume remains constant. So every time as the flow increases, the time requirement is reduced. So in this, we are gradually increasing the flow. So in order to measure the discharge, we use volume divided by time. Volume is 1000 cc into 10 raised to minus this is converting into meter cube per second. This is 10 raised to minus 6. Because 10 raised to minus 3, that is actually centimeter cube. Then multiply by, so this generally convert cc into meter cube, that is 10 raised to minus 6. Or we can say cc into 10 raised to minus 3, that is cubic centimeter. Or liter, this 1000, that is called as a liter. So liter into 10 raised to minus 3 divided by time. So that gives the discharge. So we can calculate the discharge as well. So only by putting the time value in this expression, we can calculate the discharge. Then we can calculate the velocity, that is Q by A. So discharge known to us, area of the cube is already calculated. So by dividing by area, we can calculate the velocity of the flow. And we can calculate the Reynolds number, that is Vd by nu, diameter of the pipe known to us, velocity known to us, kinematic viscosity. So these are the various Reynolds number. And this is our observed observation of the type of physical observations. So now for reading number one, we have observed the flow is laminar. That means we have observed the thin filament inside the glass tube. That means the flow is laminar. And after calculation, the Reynolds number, it comes around 1500. Means it is less than 2000. That means our flow is, whatever our observation, it is verified with the help of Reynolds number. So similarly, second reading again, we have observed the laminar flow. Reynolds number is coming less than 2000. Third reading also, it is coming 2000, less than 2000. So first three readings, our observation is laminar flow. And also it is verified with the help of Reynolds number. It is coming less than 2000. Then the fourth and fifth reading, we are getting unstable film. So slight wavy nature of the film. And we have calculated the Reynolds number. It is between 2000 to 4000 in both cases. So that film becomes unstable. So this is a transition zone, we can say. And fifth, sixth and seventh reading, where we found the complete haphazard movement of the fluid particles. The film is completely diffuse over the entire cross section that we have observed in sample animation film. So there we have validated, we observed, we have calculated Reynolds number that is coming greater than 4000. That means whatever the our observations, we have verified with the help of Reynolds number. So all our observations have been verified. So this is about the experiment. So only the fundamental things we have verified with the help of calculation or by calculating the Reynolds number. That's it from this particular experiment. As far as the conclusion of this experiment is concerned, so Reynolds experiment is performed to verify the type of flow. And now in order to recognize the flow, the color dye is injected in the flow passage. So color dye is nothing but the color water, only to recognize the uncolored layer and colored layer. So the dye is injected, that is called as a strict line, we can say. Observed flow is also verified with the help of Reynolds number. So whatever the observation is there, so it is verified, and it is found that when the flow is laminar, the Reynolds number is also coming less than 2000. So it is found that if the observed flow is laminar, Reynolds number is calculated less than, or calculated Reynolds number is less than 2000. If the flow is unstable, the Reynolds number calculated is greater than 2000 and less than 4000. And if the observed flow is turbulent, the Reynolds number calculated is greater than 4000. So these are the conclusions. So quite simple experiment. This experiment has not any physical or practical relevance. Generally, practically, in industry, this experiment is not performed. But to validate some fundamental things, this experiment is performed at the education level or at the subject level. So to just understand the definition of laminar flow and definition of turbulent flow. These definitions Reynolds has introduced based on their physical observation. So why the flow is called as laminar? Because laminar's dictionary meaning of laminar, that is a parallel layers. So he observed that the flow is taking place in layers. So there is no cross flow or the cross component there in the laminar flow. There is only the flow is unidirectional. And especially this happens for a thick fluid. The fluid particles are moving along well-defined path. So that means, so accordingly, the Reynolds number definition or the laminar definition is introduce or it is constructed. Similarly, for turbulent flow, you observe that the fluid particles are moving entirely in haphazard or disorderly manner. So there is a rapid mixing of the fluid particles that he realized that entire color is diffused over the entire cross section. So that according to the physical observation, he constructed the definition of turbulent. And that in between there is a transition. So that is the purpose of this experiment, only at the fundamental level. So that's it. We have completed this experiment. Thank you very much.